Talmud, Sanhedrin, page 87. The sugiyah of today is the Zaken Mamre, a rebellious son. I'd like to start with a quote from the Torah that leads us to our Mishnah and our sugiyah. The Torah is a well-known text in the book of Dvarim, Deuteronomy, chapter 17, begins with verse 8. Ki yipale mimcha davar la mishpat. If a matter of judgment will be hidden for you, meaning you're not so sure, bein dam le dam, between blood and blood. Rashi tells us, based on the Gemara in Tractate Nida, page 19, this is a special tractate dealing with law of blood. So you have here a situation of judgment that regarding whether a discharge of uncertain color is considered red and will thus render a woman impure to the menstruation based on Leviticus 15 verse 19 in Rashi. So the text said between blood and blood. Blood and blood does not refer to a question caused by confusion in identifying two specimens of blood. It means between one law concerning blood and another law concerning blood. Uvein nega la nega, divrei rivot bisharecha. So again, here you have a loosely translation of the text is between affliction and affliction, matter of dispute in your cities. So dispute in the cities, meaning you have a matter that brings to the court and there are certain experts who have a different views. So what you have to do, v'kamta ve'alita el ha'makom asher ibchar Hashem Elokecha bo, you have to go and ascend to a place that the Almighty shall choose. So you go before the priest, before the Levites, before the judge in those days, and in those days meaning every generation. And they should tell you what is the word of judgment. And this is an important commandment. Let me just go in English. So they said, you shall do according to the words that they will tell you from the place that the Almighty will choose, and you should be careful to do according to everything that they will teach you, according to the teaching they will teach you, and according to the judgment that they will say to you, shall you do. You should not deviate, you should not turn from the word that they will tell you left or right, which is, even Rashi and others said, even they tell you to go left, and you feel the other way around, and vice versa. Now here we speak about the elderly, rebellious elder. And if you have a person that will act with willfulness, not listening to the Kohen who standard to serve God or to the judge, that man shall die and you should destroy the evil from among your people. The entire nation should listen and fear, and they should not willfully do any more. So here, very clear statement in the Torah that tells us that if you have a rebellious elder, if you have a situation that someone who can be potentially a person who is a very wise man, but he's going against the Supreme Court decision, so if, as much as he is a Torah scholar, Talmid Chacham, but he rules against Beit Din HaGadol, the 71 judges, so therefore, he deserved the chenek. So here we are, the Mishnah, page 86b. So here is the word of our Mishnah Kedosha. Zaken mamre al pi beit din. You have a rebellious elder that oppose the view of beit din. Shene'emar ki ipale mimcha davar la mishpat. Because the Torah said clearly, if there should be a matter too hard for you in judgment. So you see here in a pasuk that you have to go by the rule of the court. But this person opposed it, and therefore he deserved a chenek. But the Meiri tells us an important concept. He said that a rebellious elder is liable to be executed only if his colleagues on the court rule contrary to his opinion. But if only the majority rule contrary to his opinion, although the halakha is not according to his view, he is not liable to be executed, which is important to know. But here the Mishnah elaborates and it tells us, Shlosha batei dinim ayusham. Was there three courts. Echad yoshev al petach harabayit. Was one that reside at the place, convinced at the entrance of the temple courtyard. Buchlaner and Tosfot Yom Tov tells us that the idea of petach harabayit, it's because that's the entrance from the court to the Temple Mount courtyard. It's like the gate that those who visit Yerushalayim know. It's a very interesting place. It was close to the eastern part that connected to the those days. It used to have a special women's section. So, Echad Yoshev al Petach HaBayit, the first one convened at the temple courtyard. Second one, Ve'echad Yoshev, one al Petach HaZara, a little higher in the mountain at the one is in Temple Mountain, one is the Temple Courtyard, and the third one, Ve'echad Yoshev Belishkat HaGazit, one is in the Chamber of Horns, which is that is a inside of Temple Courtyard, half in the place that consecrated, and the one with the outer part. That's Rashi tells us based on the Gemara in Yuma 25. And the Bedina Gadol, the High Supreme Court, which contains 71 judges, that's the one who was in the Lishkat HaGazit. Ba'im leze she'al petach harabayit. So first, an elder who issues ruling contrary to the ruling of the of his colleagues, so they go together to the court at the entrance of the Temple Mount. ואומר, כך דרשתי וכך דרשו חבריי, כך לימדתי וכך לימדו חבריי. So soon we see the whole idea of ascending, but anyway, they just bring to the court each one point of view. אם שמעו, אומרים להן ואם לאו. So basically, if they accept or listen, that's the way the Rambam explained. So fine. otherwise, almost like we have nowadays a court of appeal or a different category of court, so that's they go higher. Ba'in lahen leotan shel petach hazara. Remember, we said that there are three formulations of court. So you go to the higher, who resides, who convenes at the entrance of the temple courtyard. Ve'omer kach darashti v'chach darshu chaverai, kach limadti v'chach limdu chaverai. Each party presented their view. Im shamu, so omrim lahem v'im lav elu v'elu b'ayinu b'dina gadol. So again, if it's a resolution, it's good. Otherwise, you go together to the highest supreme court. Shebelishkat hagazit shemenu yotze Torah lechol Yisrael. So you go to the Chamber of Horn, where the Torah distributed to all the nation. And everyone should follow the way, because we just read in the Torah, "Shne'emar min ha'makom ahu asher yivchar Hashem," which is the Lishkat HaGazdi, the Chamber of Horn. That's the place that the Almighty reside, in a sense that they have all the conflict resolutions. And the Rambam explained that you go by the majority views. That's one of the measurement midot shaTorah nidreshit. And he said, "Chazar leiro shana v'limed b'derech she'alamed." But unfortunately, that rebellious elder returned to his location, and he teach the way that he learned before the Supreme Court rules. So patur. So he didn't make it as a practical law. He just taught. So he's exempt. Obviously, we need to know what does that mean. V'imor ala asot chayav. However, if he just rule, even the court impose on him clearly the way that they chose, by the majority or by the entire court, depending on the Meiri, etc. But it was the court rulings, and now he's a rebellious. He come back and he rule against them. So he's basically in violation of the Torah law. Shenemar, they said clearly, v'ha'ish aser yashev bezadon elo chayav kshiyoreh la'asot. So when he does that intentionally against the court, meaning the one, he's not liable until he instructs other to act in contrary to the court. Now it's another derivative which we learn a lot. We have here about students or disciples who's not yet been ordained. Talmid, so in those days he was less than 41 years old. So obviously the Gemara in Sotah 22 said that that's one of the wickedness, that one who's not ordained rules. But basically he goes ahead and he disputed the Supreme Court, Shehora la'asot patur, that if he has act contrary to the ruling of the Sanhedrin, exempt, as a ruling given prior to ordination is not valid ruling. Mishnah said, Nimtza chumro kulo. Which is, if you have a disciple, he's not ordained yet, instruct others to act in a contrary to the rule of the Sanhedrin, the 71 judges, Supreme Rabbinic Court, is exempt as the ruling given prior to ordination is not considered a valid ruling. It follows that his stringency is his leniency, which is the stringency imposed upon the students that is not sanctioned to issue rulings result in the leniency, that if he instructs others to act on the basis of his ruling that is contrary to the ruling of the Sanhedrin, he is exempt. But this is very interesting, the word of the Rambam. See also Rabbeinu Avadia Bartanura. Anyway, the Rambam said, I'm reading from the Quran edition of the translation, a rebellious elder is liable to be executed only if he is a Torah scholar, capable of issuing halachic rulings, which is a matter of Jewish law, and is authorized to do so. If he is a student who is not yet capable of issuing halachic rulings, and he instructs others to act contrary to the ruling of the great Sanhedrin, he is exempt from liability and is not executed. Obviously, so I'll start from the point that Azut Panim, Rabbeinu Avraham Baratunura said, basically caused him to be saved from death. Anyway, there is a Rashash that elaborates. Gemara. Tanu Rabbanan, we zoom in the text in Deuteronomy in Dvarim, chapter 17, verse 8. And as we translated earlier, Ki yipale mimcha davar. Yipale, in general, is something that you wonder, that it's not clear, it's too hard for you rule. So why they use the word yipale? Yipale, it's like kind of pele, it's unclear. 87, bemufla, mufla, in a sense that it's an expert, is a specialist, is distinguished, shebevet dina katuv medaber. It's someone who's a very erudite, who's familiar with all the laws. The Igrot Moshe, Rav Feinstein, in Choshen Mishpat, Chelek Aleph, Siman Aleph, he brings more what exactly involved here, if it's that applied to the ordination, or what exactly involved here. Tosfot said, Mumche lema'utei talmid ve'en ze kesh'ar mufla shebechol duchtin. But the way that the Rambam said, a rebellious elder is liable to be executed only if he's a Torah scholar who's qualified to issue halachic ruling. So obviously you talk about an expert, mimcha, ze yo'etz. So for you, it's someone who's giving counsel, who's advice. So the Rambam in Ilchut Kiddush HaChodesh, chapter 11, said that someone who's very familiar with astrology, astronomy, all the, which is called Soda Yibur, knowing the intercalation more. וכן הוא אומר, this is a quote from the book of Nahum, chapter 1, ממך יצא חושב על השם, ראה יועץ בלי יעל. So the pasuk said, from you he emerged, who advised evil against the Lord, an advisor of wickedness. So here's there is derivative that it's הלכה למשה מסיני, that we learn the Rashash said from the Gvura, it's not from one of those utterances. דבר זו הלכה, למשפט זה הדין, which is judgment, is the logical inference, which is one of the hermeneutical principle. That's obviously the gzera shava, the juxtaposition of text. Bin dam ledam, bin dam nida, dam leida, dam ziva. So in very general, dam nida is the period that it's basically 7 days of the time of the period. Then you have the time of Yemei Ziva, that's the 11 days. And one who's delivered a child, it was said in Leviticus chapter 15, we differentiate between baby boy and baby girl, that 1 week for baby boy, 2 weeks for girl, and then it's 40 days for the boy and 80 days for the girl. After that is a regular manner of nida. בין דין לדין, בין דיני נפשות, דיני ממנות, דיני מכות, בין נגע לנגע, בין נגעי אדם, נגעי בתים, נגעי בגדים, דברי אלו החרמים וערכים בהקדשות. So the utterances, that's applied to all the dedications to God or to a Kohen, and valuation of one value to the temple, and the consecrations, all of which matter to, of speech. ריבות זו השקעת סוטה ועריפת עגלה וטהרת מצורע וישריך זולקת שכחה ופאה. So basically you see here all these different words in the text that applies to different court ruling in those different subjects. So as long as he's disputed the court, so he's all the rules of rebellious elderly rebellious applies to that. So they said vekamta, then you should arise. So now from the time that they convince the court, convene, you stand. Mi bet din ve'alita el melamed shebet hamikdash gavua me'eretz Yisrael ve'eretz Yisrael gavua mikol ha'aretzot el ha'makom melamed shehamakom gorem. So here we talk about the level of ascending. So we derive from that the holy temple, it's higher than the others. And Eretz Yisrael is the higher from all. So the Chatam Sofer in the response, השאלות ותשובות יובד היער, יש לה מדלת, he asked a question, the whole world is כדורי, is around. So that's basically the highest place, and how you tell me that Eretz Yisrael or the whole world is higher than... So it brings the... for example, the Tehillim in Kuf Lamed Gimel says, הר חרמון יורד על הרי ציון, so you can find here that it's higher. So he explained that the way that the Chazal tells us about the Eben Shtiya, that especially was the flowing spring river that bring water to the whole world. So that's the foundation of the world, is in Beit HaMikdash. And from there, the whole world turned to be round. So that's the idea of Gavua. Gavua, it means Nivra, Yonek, came from, and that's basically you see in Maharal, in Be'er HaGola, Be'er HaShishi, he explained it. Yes.
I have a question.
Yes.
Does the water mean actual water, or is it spiritually
like water? If you go by the literal text, it's a good question. It's real, but if you go by the Maharal, it's a spiritual. But the whole concept, if you go by the literal text, is the idea, if you read the literature that speaks about the end of the days, so the whole water of the world will flow and come to being from the Beit HaMikdash. Anyway, it's a good point. So here we talk about the heights. So, but as we said, that the Maharal, Maharsha, Chatam Sofer, many others have a discussion, what do you mean by saying high, highs of all the others? Bishlama bet hamikdash gavoa me'eretz Yisrael lechtiv ve'alita. We understand that the Holy Temple is higher than Eretz Yisrael because the text said that you should ascend. Ela Eretz Yisrael gavoa mekorotzot min ha'alei. How do you know that Eretz Yisrael is higher? Lechtiv lachen yamim ba'im nom Hashem. לא יאמרו עוד חי השם אשר אלי בני ישראל מארץ מצרים כי אם חי השם אשר אלי וביא את זרע בית ישראל מארץ צפון מכל הארצות שדחתים שם וישובו לאדמתם. So Jeremiah said in chapter 23 that this is the coming from other countries to Eretz Israel is also a characterized as aliyah, to ascend. תנו רבנן זקן אמרי אינו חייב אלא על דבר שזדונו כרת ושגיגתו חטאת. So the obligation to punish the rebellious elder, it's only if he instructed the matter with intentional violation, one is liable to receive correct, and with unintentional violation is liable to bring a sin offering. That's the view. דברי רבי מאיר, רבי יהודה אומר, על דבר שיקרו מדברי תורה ופירושו מדברי סופרים, with the essence of the Torah, and then they have the oral teaching, or one of the midot, one of the principles that the Torah did derive, and he basically disputed them, the elderly who was a rebellious one. Rabbi Shimon omer afilu dikduk achad midikduki sofrim. Rabbi Shimon said, even you talk about miniature of scribes, and so it means that if he just disputed whatever can be one of the 13 principles or things like that, as long as he's rebellious, there's a problematic. So you have here different views between the Ran and others, what exactly the Rambam, what exactly and how far. In general essence, the Ran said that if Ikaro Meforash Batorah, if it's elusively or unambiguously written clearly in the Torah, and he rebel against it by ruling opposed the opposite way, then he's under the category of Zaken Mamre, rebellious. Ma'ita Amadei Rabbi Meir, Gamar Davar Davar. You learn the verbal analogy, the juxtaposition, because they use the word Mera, Davar. So they said, K'tivacha, and Zaken Mamre, it's written, Ki Palem Imcha Davar Lamishpat, K'tivatam V'Ne'elam Davar Mene HaKal. מה להלן דבר שחייב על זנו כרת ועל שגיגתו חטאת? אף כאן דבר שחייב על זנו כרת ושגיגתו חטאת. ורבי יהודה, רבי יהודה said, the Torah said clearly על פי הדבר של ירוחה, the way that they instructed you. So, עד יעיק התורה וירוחה, until is a matter, it's consist of the element of both written Torah, in that the sages shall instruct you in interpretation of the written Torah. ורבי שמעון אשר הביאו לך מן המקום ההוא אפילו כל דהו. So in a sense, he says even a small minute point of the דקדוקי סופרים. אמר לרב הונא בר חינא לרבה תרגמא לילאי מתנידא דעני בד רב מאיר. אמר לרבה לרב פאפא פוק תרגמא לי. כי יפלא, when you use the term, it shall be a matter too hard. במופלא שבבית הדין הכתוב מדבר. That applies to the most distinguished member of the court. ממך זה יועץ שיודע להבר שנים ולקבוע חדשים. לתנן, הוא לא יונתן משנה אינטרקטד עליות, chapter 7, משנה 7, הן, which is רבי יהושע ורבי פפאיאס, העידו שמעברים את השנה כל אדר, they make interclination of the year, the entire month of אדר, and it turned that they make it even before Purim, but it's already read the Megillah, and then they find the need to make it a double with the interclination. So Rabbi Yoshua and Rabbi Papayas need to give her witnesses. Shayu Omrim, sages would say, Ad HaPurim, they said that you should not make it until the day of Purim. So the Gemara in Rosh Hashanah, page 7, said that otherwise it caused takala, it caused problems. Because we have 30 days before Pesach, we already discussed the law of Pesach, and it creates a lot of problems and confusion. So they said, "De'i lehai gisa kashari chametz b'Pesach, ve'le'al gisa kashari chametz b'Pesach," because then you basically permit the consumption of leavened bread of Pesach according to the calendar established by the Sanhedrin. So that's the reason why you have to impose upon him this type of punishment. One who is intentionally eats leavened bread on Pesach is liable to receive karet, and one who does so unintentionally is liable to bring a sin offering. Davar, so a matter, ze halacha. Halacha of Moshe Mesinai, that's the rule that we receive in tradition from Moses and Sinai. And Rav Papa explained, zo ilchot achad asar, that's the law of 11 days of ziva that we believe we receive from Moses in Sinai. And obviously it can be changed, but the whole concept is halacha of Moshe Mesinai. He said, "Deitmar asiri, Rabbi Yochanan mer asiri ketchiv, Rabbi Shimon mer kishem asiri ke'achad asar." So how you do the tenth if it's like a 9 or like 11? Rabbi Yochanan mer asiri ketchi, matchi by shimu, af asiri by shimu, v'yesh l'gishamar asiri ke'achad asar. Ma echad asar lo by shimu, af asiri lo by shimu. So basically, Rabbi Shlakish hold that the status of the 10th day is like the 11th day. The same way as the discharge of the 11th day does not require observance of a day clean from discharge for immersion in the mikveh, the same way as discharge of the 10th, it's not. Mishpat. So we have here this different view between Rabbi Yochanan and Shlakish. Again, Rabbi Yochanan amar asiri ketshi'i, ma tshi'i ba'i shimur, fa'asiri ba'i shimur, ve'yesh Lakish amar asiri ke'echad asar, ma echad asar lo ba'i shimur, fa'asiri lo ba'i shimur. So therefore she allowed to cohibit to the husband. And it means that according to Rabbi Lakish, we have two rules that apply to the 11th day. According to Rabbi Yochanan, it's only one. So the Uchlaner explained that basically this involved with karet, because Zava prohibited to her husband the same as Nida, she have the same karet. So, because the Torah said in Leviticus 15, Kol Yemei Zov Tumata Kimei Nidata Tiye. Our Papa continues, Mishpat, judgment, Ze Hadin, that's the Gzera Shava, the logical inference, which is one of the hermeneutical principle. To what type of Gzera Shava the Tana meant? 7b, Din Bito Me'anusato. For example, the halacha of prohibiting against engaging in a relation with one's daughter born from the victim of the person's rape. So the Amar Rav Amar Li Rav Yitzchak Bar Avdini Atya Hena Henya Atya Zima Zima. So that's the verbal analogy. Ben dam le dam, ben dam nida le da, dam le da dam ziva. Dam nida beflugta, akav ben olel verabanan, detnan dam hayarok. Akav ben olel mitame v'chamim tarim. So it's a green blood. According to akav ben olel, it says that it's blood of menstruation and impure. According to the sages, it's pure. So according to akav ben olel, one who engages in intercourse with a woman who discharge green blood is liable to receive karet, while according to the sages is exempt. Dam leda befulta de Rabbi Levi, Eitmar Rav Amar, Ma'ayan Echadu, Atorah Metamato, Atorah Tiarto. Say that once, according to Rav, is just one source of blood, so therefore the Torah deem impure and pure. Ve'levi Amar Shnei Ma'alot, said two sources. Therefore, Hem Nistam Atame, Niftach Atorah, Nistam Atame, Niftach Atame. דם זיווה בפלוטה לרבי אליעזר רבי יהושע דתנן קישתה שלושה ימים בתוך 11 יום אם שפטה מעת לעת וילדה הרי זו ילד בזוב דברי רבי אליעזר רבי יהושע אומר לילה ויום כללי שבת ויומו ששפטה מן הצער ולא מן הדם בין דין לדין בדיני ממונות דיני הנפשות דיני מכות דיני ממונות בפלוטה לשמואל רבי אבאו אמר שמואל שם שדם דיניהם דין שנקראים בדין חצוף רבי אבאו אמר לברא כל הם דיניהם דין. So again, the court of two, either that's considering a ruled one, but they still accepted them, or it's not valid rule. Dinei nefeshot befulta de Rabbi v'Rabbanan, detanei Rabbi Meir v'natat nefesh tachat nefesh, mamon. So that's a mandatory payment. Atam mamon ol nefesh mamash, nimon tina lemala, nimon lemata, mala mamon, afkan mamon. Dinei makot, the law of makot, of lashes. Here you go, Bifluta Rabbi Shmuel Rabbanan Ditnan, מכות בשלושה משום רבי שמואל אמרו ב-23. בנגע לנגע בנגעי אדם נגני בתים נגני בגדים. נגעי אדם בפיוק תדר רבי יהושע ורבנן דתנן אם בערת קדם לשיער הלבן, תמי אם שיער לבן קדם לבערת, טהור. ספק תמי רבי יהושע אומר קאה מה קאה, אמרה בקאה טהור. נגעי בתים בפיוק תדר רבי אלעזר ורבי שמעון ורבנן דתנן. רבי אלעזר ורבי שמעון אומר עולם מן הבית תמי עד שיראה כשני גריסים על שתי אבנים כשהם בשתי כתלים וקרן זווית אורכו כשני גריסים ורוחבו כגריס. מה איתם עד רבי אלעזר ורבי שמעון? כתיב קיר וכתיב קירות וזהו קיר שהוא כקירות ואומר זה קרן זווית. נגעי בגדים בפלוטה לרבי יונתן נבטולמוס רבנן דתניא רבי יונתן נבטולמוס אומר מניים יעית לפריחה בבגדים שהיא טהורה נאמרה קרחת וגבחת באדם ונאמרה קרחת וגבחת בבגדים מלאלן פרח בקולו טהור אף כאן פרח בקולו טהור דברי הלו הערכים והחרמים וההקדשות ערכים בפלוטה לרבי מאיר ורבנן דתנן המעריך פחות מבן חודש רבי מאיר אומר נותן דמה וחכמים אומרים לא אמר כלום החרמים בפלוגתא דרבי יהודה בן בטרה ברבנן דתנן רבי יהודה בן בטרה אומר סתם חרמים לפלג הבית שנאמר כל חרם קודש קודשים מול השם והחרם אומרים סתם חרמים לכהן שנאמר כזדה חרם לכהן תהיה אחוזתו אם כן מה תלמוד לומר קודש קודשים מול השם שחל על קודשי קודשים ועל קודשים קלים הקדשות בפלוגתא דרבי אליעזר בן יעקב ורבנן דתניא רבי אליעזר בן יעקב אומר אפילו צינורה של הקדש צריכה עשרה בני אדם לפדותה